Hello, you multi mash house mice. Yes, I'm Ralphie, ralphie.com, in the Manx bothy, doing some whisky reviews. This is whisky review 394, and a big thank you to the malt bar for that malt mention. Now, our whisky's a little bit different from the usual because, in fact, it's a bourbon. And here in Whisky Review 394, we are concluding a nice long series of quality American bourbons and other spirits. So that includes the other spirits, means this fascinating corn whisky from Balcones Distillery, which gives a variation in the theme. But we're concluding this review with arguably the best-selling bourbon in the United States, and it's got a big punch because it's 101 proof, so 50.5% alcohol. Lovely stuff. It's called Wild Turkey. It's a straight bourbon. It doesn't have an age statement on it as far as I can see. Excuse me, I better double check. No, it gives you a wee blurb. It's from the Nichols Distilling Company, Lawrenceburg. Well, at least we have a forthright declaration as to who's distilled it. I appreciate that. With this bourbon, I will most certainly be adding some water because I want to get past that alcoholic nip, which can actually disguise some of the flavours. One, two, three teaspoons. So I'm being quite generous with the water for the simple reason that I've had a few glasses of this bourbon, and you know, with a little drop of water, that's the way I enjoy it. Now, tasting notes. One of the things I've noticed immediately about Wild Turkey that I have enjoyed is that it's not as sweet as many others. This is a more of a semi-sweet, subtle, almost savoury sour mash style, which it took me a little time to get used to it, but now that I am, I'm really enjoying it because it most certainly adds some natural character to this, what this bourbon is. There's a sort of dense woody note to it as well. I don't know whether it's the yeast they're using. I suspect it is the yeast varieties contributing heavily to this style. But there is certainly quite a dense quality, savoury figginess going on. Bitter corn, hints of absinthe, herbal, green ginger, vanilla, brulee, lemongrass, camphor, eau de cologne, rose water and cinnamon. So some classic bourbon notes in there, the cinnamon, rose water, cola, but it's really kind of counterbalanced by that savoury herbal note, which is adding something additional to this, making, in terms of quality, making this really quite good value. Taste wise, bittersweet and spicy. Geranium. It took me a while to pin that one down. Also angelica. So you're getting some bitter green herbal notes here. Hint of bay leaf. Quite soft corn content. Savoury rye. I think the rye, actually, the content, and this, there's certainly rye involved in this. That's adding quite an interesting dimension to this. In fact, very nicely balanced in terms of corn and rye. Clove, cinnamon, rose water, melon, cucumber, wood spice, lime leaves, apricot and almond. So you're getting an element of nuttiness as well. So really quite sophisticated, rounded, full-flavoured bourbon, this. I can understand its popularity. And I must also comment on the consistency of the batching of this. I have phoned a friend, as I do occasionally, for some dispassionate advice, and I was thoroughly recommended to go ahead and review this. So that's what we do. When you get advice from friends, you just follow it up and take the chance. Glad I did. I'm enjoying this. The finish is apricot, vanilla, tannin and lemon juice. And Mark, ...87 out of 100, and that is a bourbon mark. There you go. This particular wild turkey, it's really concluding my reviews, my series on American bourbons. I will be coming back to them again next year in 2014, but we're not quite finished yet, because my next whiskey review, 395, will be, excuse me, is that the right one? Yep, 395. I'm going to start a hat trick of rye whiskies. So we're not quite finished with American spirits yet. But I will conclude by saying that you have some good mainstream options here with this Wild Turkey 101, particularly for the price. And the general availability, particularly outside of the United States. But one has to be careful, because you can get some really nicely packaged stuff which is perhaps kind of lacking in a rounded quality. So buyer beware. There are plenty of resources online relating to commentators for bourbon. Chuck Cowdery is a good example. Just Google his name, and also Jason Pyle, although I noticed Jason hasn't been reviewing some bourbons on YouTube for a wee while, so hopefully he'll be putting his oar in again shortly. But there is quite a lot of material out there for guidance. But what would be a good idea is perhaps to have a library of opinions, rather like the whiskey base, which is for Scotch whiskey and world whiskies, but specifically for bourbons and American spirits, as a point of reference online, so people can get different opinions at one point. My opinion is, interesting times, because apart from the traditional bourbons, which tend to kind of follow a pattern and a fairly orthodox conservative theme in what they present in terms of smell and taste, you've got such an exciting range of new generation American whiskies. And I'm going to point them out on the map here. You've got Clear Creek up in Oregon. You've got Stranahan's in Colorado. You've got Balcones in Waco in Texas. And these are simply three whiskies I have reviewed from very different geographical areas on the United States. The B, by the way, is for Bonneville. That's not a whiskey. That's the Salt Flats, where the racing goes on. And in 2014, just to give it a mention, is the centenary of the Bonneville Speed Trials. And if you follow whiskey stuff, you'll notice that I'm helping out a motorcycle team who are already world record holders, and they're going back to Bonneville in 2014. So we wish them all the best. You will notice me periodically waving the Manx flag for them, because they are world record holders and I do believe they can do it again. Simple as that. So that's us concluded our series on American bourbon and whiskey reviews. Our next three reviews will be specifically rye. And after that, well, we'll be starting to go on location. Thanks for joining me. I'm Ralphie. This has been another quality moment here in the Manx Bothy, and I hope you have found this useful, helpful, and all the rest of it. Main thing is, enjoy whatever you're drinking, but don't let whatever you're drinking spoil your day. That's important. Cheers for now.